up your hand. Say, Father, thank you for your word. We hear it. We receive it. We believe that we may be a doer of it. You increase. We decrease. We give you praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. One of the expressions that that people use a lot has to do with changes. You know, when people change, there's many different expressions. I remember learning about the butterfly when you first born again. Who heard the caterpillar in the butterfly? Everybody knows the caterpillar into a butterfly, but before I was born again, I didn't know. So when people were trying to encourage me and tell me, don't worry, one day you're gonna be a butterfly, I thought, is that incarnation? I mean, am I gonna die and then become a butterfly? That didn't sound too appealing to me. Like to die and then you become a butterfly one day. And I didn't know that was encouraging me with my life at a time, right? And then when I was born again, this incredible thing happened in my life when I was born again, when you were born again, is that suddenly I was transformed. I was transformed. I became a new creation. I was transformed. And when I thought back of the caterpillar and the butterfly, I finally understood what they meant. Because then I could see. Not everything, but I could see. And I could understand that even though the caterpillar still looked like a caterpillar, the caterpillar in the DNA is created to fly. And that the whole purpose of the caterpillar, their purpose is to fly one day. That's their purpose. And I started studying and more from glory to glory, this process of walking into the transformation once you are transformed. And when I look at you, and as the under-shepherd of this church, my greatest heart is to see people walk into transformation. And I can tell you that I see that in your life. And one of the things that the Lord said in the word that, who's been praying the word that that he gave us for this year? Who's been praying it? Well, it's somewhere in between all these pages. Who's been praying it? My goodness. What over here? What? All right, then. When the Lord tells us things, we come in agreement with what he says. And since the beginning of the year, the Holy Spirit has been leading me to go through what he said and to teach on it at every service. Amen? In other words, for some reason, the Holy Spirit really wants us to pay attention to it. That even when I get busy and I forget a few days, he had people reminding me. Hallelujah. So, and there's some copies out there for you to pick up, and I emailed it. But I just want to read what we covered so far. He said, arise and shine, my people, for many in the world are looking for the light in the midst of darkness surrounding them. My glory will arise upon you increasingly. Do not let the darkness hinder the light you carry. I will enable you to reach forth for all that I have already provided to secure your victory. I have released every spiritual blessing upon you. Until now, you have been held back by trials and oppression. This is the season of your release. Now, all these things that he said are truth of the gospel of the kingdom. But in that truth, there's seasons in the Lord that you walk in greater revelation and in greater purpose in what he has for you and what he has set forth in place. He said, your stand will be on the true righteousness you have in Christ. You will walk in the Spirit, free from religion, and be led by my Spirit to do extraordinary exploits. And we've been learning what that means, to walk in the Spirit, to walk in love. We've been learning, and even the Lord is giving us even insight that in this season he's going to help us walk in the Spirit like never before, even between now and when we celebrate resurrection. We are going to walk in the Spirit like never before. And then he said, I'm leading you to they should come up with an expression with me for this one. I'm leading you to prioritize your relationship with me, to seek and worship me above all, to turn off some words in order to hear my word. And without going through all the messages, but last Wednesday night, the message on wisdom was just amazing. How it's connecting the fruit and the gifts and all the messages you can listen on YouTube. And I'm in the process of putting them in writing so you can read them. And then it says, I am moving speedily, bringing a quick transformation, into the image of Christ. It will happen quickly and be unstoppable. A quick transformation. One of the things that the Lord said is that he's going to lead us to complete some things, to bring some things to completion, to be done with some things already. And so to me, that means that that's his greatest purpose, his mission statement, is that we are transformed into the image of Jesus from glory to glory. That's this greatest man. So he who began a good work will finish. So in this season, he's going to bring us to transformation quickly. Now, what's the difference between change and transformation? Change to me, because you hear change so much everywhere you turn. You have to make a change. I'm going to bring a change. Let's all go for a change. I'm going to change my ways. I'm going to change my hair. I'm going to change the color of my eyes. I'm going to change my car. If there's anything that people are after, is always a change. There's self-help out there everywhere you turn because people want to change something. They figured if they change something, maybe their life will change. So they try to change. They change mates on a regular basis. Because they figured if I change mate, maybe things will change. If I change the place where I live, maybe everything's going to change. Maybe if I change jobs, I will have more money. Because, of course, it's not what I do with the money, it's the job. Of course, it's not me, it's the mate. And then every January 1st, well, I'm going to try to change a little bit that I might have going on with me. I'm going to change. I'm going to lose 15 pounds in 30 days. And I saw the commercial that said that if you take this one thing, the pounds will melt away. Did you see that? Did other people see that commercial? All by themselves, right? And you can just see this magical way to change. Take a pill and the pounds just melt away. The best one is when you can eat everything you want and the pounds still melts away. And all you have to do is send 99.99. And then the change happens. And you have the whole world looking for a change. When I was young, I was part of the hippie movement, as you know, because I just grabbed a hold of the change. To me, that was a change. That was something that was bringing a revolution, a change. Hallelujah. Change is what people look for. But there's this one problem with all these examples that I'm giving you, is people trying to change something on the outside, thinking that maybe by doing that, something's going to happen and they're going to be happy on the inside. Well, change really also means that if you change something, you can change it back. Quick. If you're trying to lose weight, for example, and you said, okay, every morning I'm going to, instead of a croissant, Miss Ware used croissant for an example. Instead of a croissant, every morning I'm going to have, well, let's say, a yogurt with granola. Not bad, huh? And fruits, okay. So you make a change, and you go to the store, you get the yogurt, and you can last like that maybe until, I don't know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, whatever. But all the time that you do it, there's not really been a change. Because when you eating the yogurt, you think about the croissant. You count the days until you can have a croissant again. You eat the yogurt, but you don't even feel like you have fulfilled any desires, because all you think is about the croissant. What the world needs is not a change. Oh, I should become a politician. No, I'm just kidding. Where's the joke? Phew. What the world needs, gonna preach the kingdom, is not a change. What the world needs is a transformation, is to be touched by the Spirit of God, to become more born again, so that they can be instantly transformed into a new creation. Because once you become a new creation and you are transformed, then the Holy Spirit helps you change, even when you're not trying, even when you're not thinking. Then you're able not to have the croissant, and you don't even want the croissant anymore. You don't even think of Egypt. You don't cry about Egypt. You're a new creation. You know that the Lord takes you from glory to glory, and you know that He has changed you. He has changed you, and because He has transformed you, then everything around you changes, because you are transformed from the inside out. Everything outside of you cannot remain the same. What the people need is to hear about this transformation. We have the answer. I pray and believe that in this season, because you come at glory to glory, I know, because I go eat to some of the places you go eat. And some of the waitress tells us, oh yeah, we had some, you must go from to glory to glory. Because other people from glory to glory, they talk about the Lord. They talk about transformation. They're releasing the truth everywhere they are. And as you do that, then people that need to change something in their life, I mean, wouldn't it be awesome, all these people that are looking for the perfect diet? Wouldn't it be awesome to be able to remind the people that the moment that you have a transformation and you're born again, you become the temple of the Holy Spirit? Once you become the temple of the Holy Spirit, He's going to help you when you decide to let go of the croissant. He's going to help you once you know who you are. The scripture tells us, I printed the message, I printed the version of the message of Romans chapter 12, just because you know that scripture so well. The New King James in chapter 12 of Romans says, it says in verse 1, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And then it says what? And do not be conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. The message, because just sometimes it's good for you to hear it a different way. Thank you, Mary Beth, for blessing me with the message one day. Shout out! Shout out to Mary. It says, so here's what I want you to do, God helping you. Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life, and place it before God as an offering. Wow. Whoa. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for Him. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Whoa, ouch. Instead, fix your attention on God. You will be changed from the inside out. Readily recognize what He wants from you and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down to its level of immaturity, God brings the best out of you and develops a well-formed maturity in you. Wow. That's transformation. When you're a new creation in Christ, when you're born again, we become a new creation, and that process is called regeneration. And that regeneration destroys everything that comes from generation. You are now born again. What Jesus has done, He has done. So now it's done. You're a butterfly. Right? So regeneration means you are born again. You have been crucified with the Lord. Your life is risen in Him. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. You are victorious in Him. You are the bride of Christ. You are more than a conqueror. That's the work of regeneration. Now, the work of sanctification that the Holy Spirit brings is because you are transformed, regenerated, that transformation, that regeneration, then there's the transformation that that allows you, through the work of transformation, you see the Holy Spirit bring sanctification in your life, which He helps you be transformed into the image of who you are in the Spirit, but He helps you walk it out and be transformed into that reality. So in other words, because you've been changed, then you can change. Yes. Yes. Because you believe what He has done, you can let Him do the rest and yield your will to His will. Because you are a new creation, all the rest is easy to allow the Holy Spirit from glory to glory. You can believe and walk in the work of sanctification. Amen. But the thing that happens is many times there's too much preaching on one area and not of the other. So if all people hear is the sanctification, and then they're going to tell others, I'm trying to change. I'm trying to change. I'm doing okay, but yeah, I'm really pressing on. I really want to get better. Really want to change. I really want to get there. And it's hard, you know. It's hard to get there when you try on your own. You cannot do it. You cannot do it because you're trying to eat yogurt, but really your mind is thinking about the croissant. But the moment that you learn to go back and drink from the oasis of regeneration, then sanctification is not something that you press through to do with your fleshy effort, but it's from having drunk that water that refreshes you of the truth of who you are in Him, that then you can allow Him and see some of the changes happen in your life. So instead of changing your mate, if you married, now suddenly you go to the oasis of transformation, believing that God is able to change your marriage, to change your relationship, to transform everything that is in your life. If you struggle with anything in your body, you drink of the truth that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. That's the regeneration. Then you can believe and have faith for the sanctification, for the change in your habits, in your temple, because you're drinking from the oasis of the regeneration. So by His stripes you were healed. Hallelujah. So when you seek and you press through in your own flesh, you have no water, no life. You go back to the oasis of regeneration. It's like a man in the desert. Like a man in the desert. That man that walks in the desert is going to make sure he has enough bottles of water. And he's going to make sure that he never runs out. Because he knows that without the water, and for me the water is the precious Holy Spirit that helps you to read the word, to know the truth, to bring glorification to the Son, to help you even behold Him as in a mirror, behold the glory of the Lord, so that you can be transformed from glory to glory. To reflect His glory, to behold Him. It's huge. This man in the desert, if he runs out of water, he runs out of steam, I call it. And somebody say, hey, I have some water. You want to stop and get refreshed? If he says, no, man, I got to press on. I'm going to change. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. No, I got this. I got this. I don't need anybody to help me. Then even as a man of God or a woman of God, if you stay any day without the water, then you're going to try to do something, anything, on your own flesh. And when it comes to not being conformed to the world, how much do we need water? In the world, in this season, like never before, we need to be reminded of the oasis in our life, of who Jesus is, of what he has done, so that we don't walk in our lives starting to be conformed to the world and trying to change the way they want us to change. We here with a kingdom mindset. We have the king. We're here to spread the news of the gospel to everybody else so that they can be transfigured, changed instantly, so that they too can know that they can come unto Jesus and drink. They can come unto him and drink. So that out of your belly, he said, rivers of living water will flow. The Lord says, I'll change you quickly, he says. He says he's going to bring a transformation into his image quickly. What has been hindering him from doing it quickly is because he gave us free will, to will to his will, to allow him to do the work of sanctification. But there come a point because of his plan that he's like, hey, all right, we got to do this now. It's time now. So when it's time, the Holy Spirit is like, okay, you've been trying for 50 years. Great, great, great try. But now I'm going to just take this bucket of water and splash it on you and slack it on you. And I'm going to transform you into my image quickly, without even understanding what happened. You're gonna walk in the Spirit. You're gonna walk on water. You're gonna make exploits. You're gonna be filled with my glory. I'm gonna cause you to behold my glory, and the glory of the Lord is going to change you from glory to glory, because I have transformed you. You have been regenerated. You now have my DNA. You are a child of God. You belong to me. So now, Heremase, now the Lord says, I'm going to cause you to walk speedily into what I have for you. In other words, you're going to walk in my character now. You're going to be able now to minister to others without even always looking at the change that you need to make before you minister to somebody. You're going to stop looking and at $99.99 here and $29.99 there for a course to change this and the seven method to do this better, and five methods to and let's learn how the caterpillar crawl, and let's learn how the caterpillar, what food should the caterpillar eat, and where should we buy this food for the caterpillar? And if one day you mature enough, maybe you'll clip a wing. Maybe we'll see a wing. Maybe if you can belong to the church of the cocoons brokers, then your cocoon can be broken. And maybe if you really can get your life together, and for $39.99, I can teach you how other butterflies fly. We don't have time for all that. We don't even need all that. We don't have to go here and go there. All we need to do is behold him, to go to him, to behold his glory, to reflect it everywhere we go, to turn to the Lord. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, and to allow the Holy Spirit to do what he has to do. That's what we're supposed to do. The enemy comes to distract people with all these things, to try to do a change, when really, when you drink of the oasis of regeneration, then the sanctification happens. The body of Christ has been focusing on this and that, and then you hear, well, now if for 59, I'm making all this up, 59.99, now if you take this course and if you come to my church, then you can learn how to be part of the bride of Christ. Because not everybody is part of the bride of Christ. Now, you all be regenerated, and you all in Christ, and Jesus is the head of one body, but I have revelation, and I desire to cut some parts and decide that not everybody is going to be part of the bride. No, don't listen to all this stuff. Go back to the simple truth of the gospel. Hear it, preach it, drink it, go to the Lord. Out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. Jesus didn't complicate anything. Jesus, even the word say, oh, that you will not be taken away from the simplicity that is in Christ. Amen. What is it today that you've been praying to change in your life? Not who you're trying to change, unless it's yourself. Amen. I heard somebody say, well, I'm giving it. Okay. Because truly, as we today, as we drink like never before, because the precious Holy Spirit is here, as we drink from the oasis of regeneration, of the truth of the gospel, the Lord is going to fill you in such a way that you're gonna start being transformed just by you yielding your will. I don't know how to explain it, but it's almost like I'm going down. I feel a schlag anointing. You know, I started, when I pray for people, I schlag. And somebody one day, they said, what does that mean, Pastor, schlag? And I remember the first time it started happening is the power of the Holy Spirit comes so strong on people that a schlack is like a big bucket of water that changes people instantly. I have seen lives change instantly. No self-help program, no money spent, nothing. The same way that my life has been changed, I delight in schlacking. I'm raising up schlackers. And once a schlacker, always a schlacker. And when you are schlacked, you are schlacked to schlack others. You schlack when you spread the glory, when you release the glory upon people. You're a schlacking machine. We can get little business cards, you know, and instead of apostle and prophets, and this is a season that the titles don't mean nothing. You know, what matters is people that do something, you know, so, because, you know, you could call yourself an apostle, nobody. You could call yourself a prophet, but never hear anything from the Lord. You could call yourself a teacher, but teach some what somebody else said that you downloaded online on www.revelation.com. So many. Revelation.com. Let's ask Mr. Google how to set the captives free. Reason, if thou shalt not Google. Do not Google. Don't Google falling. Don't Google, is it okay for Pastor Jay to schlack? I've never heard of anybody else schlacking, but I call it schlacking because I see people being changed with one touch. And when that touch comes, it's like, you know, it's like schlack. It's like schlack. It's like an instant transformation. When people need that are dealing with things, they need to be schlacked. Amen. Now, please invite people to come to glory, but don't tell them, hey, you want to come to my church to get schlacked? Don't say that. Just tell them, come visit the church. The pastor's got a French accent. You might not understand everything she said, but it won't take too long. She'll pray for you. Don't say schlack. She'll pray for you. Hallelujah. But then, you that are here, you know about the schlack. So now it's time to be schlacked. Hallelujah. It's time after this word for you to experience the touch of the Holy Spirit, that even though you've already been transformed, many of you need a refreshing touch. You haven't even had time to go to the oasis. You're going through something and you need strength. You need a healing touch. You need wisdom. You need the Holy Spirit. You need a touch of water to strengthen you, to renew you, to help you on your journey. Because you are in this desert, you are in the world, and it's a tough journey. And you know, really, the church service is supposed to be a filling station. Let's be filled. That's why we're here. To receive what we need to be able to go through the desert this week. To be so filled today with a schlack that tomorrow when you get to your job, just because you're there and you're walking in, you're bringing the schlack with you. So it's not just about us being transformed, but isn't it also about transforming our neighborhood, our family, our cities, our nations? Hallelujah. Don't we pray that? Let your kingdom come. Where do we mean it? Where is Jesus, the head of the church, going to bring it by cutting his head off? Jesus not going to cut his head off and then walk around like, you know, those K movie and say, okay, my body, you no good, stay over there, and the head is over here on the throne by itself, and the Holy Spirit is there, you know, trying, oh, I better get this body back onto the head. It's hard as the Holy Spirit. No. It's not the word. He's the head of the body, one body. One spirit. Hallelujah. So it's time for you. You are the members. We are the schlackers of this generation. And none of us look the same. I love glory. I love you. I love glory to glory. I praise God for you, for raising up a church of different backgrounds, different ages, different colors, different nationality. Look at the body of Christ. One body. Right there. One body. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. One body. Look at that. Look, and the Holy Spirit did that. No, I never put pressure and say, okay, listen, in order to grow, We need to have an increase of 15% more Asian a month. No, just I just heard the music. Okay, let's do this slacking thing. So listen, when the enemy tell you the line's going to be too long, that you should go to the buffet to eat the croissant, tell the enemy, no, I need my slack touch. Hallelujah. So today, the Holy Spirit's going to be like a tsunami, like a slack. A slack, it's tsunami. You know, it's not like a little water, like, bless you. No, it's the slack, boom. Amen? It's the tsunami this morning. So stand to your feet. Tsunami. Excuse me, somebody's tsunami. Giving me an English lesson. What is it? Tsunami. Tsunami. Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Let's shout out to Jesus. Say, Jesus,
Jesus.
Shout out. For all that you have done, you died on the cross for our sins. Shout out to salvation. Shout out to healing. Shout out to freedom. Shout out to regeneration. And shout out to sanctification. We thank you for your glory. And today, we're here to drink. You said to come unto you and drink. And that if we believe, and we believe today, we are thirsty today. We come to you, Jesus. To be transformed from glory to glory. As you have said, quickly, suddenly, here we are. We receive living water. And we say, yes, Lord. We will tell everyone about you. Out of our bellies will flow rivers of living water, and we will never thirst again. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And then not just here, but even when you're at home, on your job, everywhere, many times during the day, it's okay to say, Lord, slack me. So say, Lord, slack me. Hallelujah.